Brussels sprouts and cauliflower, onion, fennel and cucumber, plum, pear and papaya, aubergine and saya, lime, lentils and quinoa, oatmeal bread and oatmeal flour, watercress and okra, tofu and sweet pepper.
Strange, this neighborhood. Here you got the Freemasons, right there. That's one thing. That's strange. However, next to here, we got an anarchist type of thing. Straight next to it, as it says there on the side, anarchist. So, two different cults, just next to each other.
The other days, I've checked out both of the vegan restaurants in the city. There are two vegetarian restaurants as well, and I plan on checking out both of them today. And quite early on that as well. So I'm now heading to a falafel place that I'm not quite sure where it is exactly. But I got the coordinates.
It is probably here, like these entire halls with restaurants. It's a thing that I'm not used to, but here it seems to be a thing. Yeah, I definitely think it's in here somewhere. I'm just gonna find that falafel place. It's not going to take too long, I think. Yeah, let's see. It's here, definitely. I'm gonna see if they actually have a really good vegan option. It's on Happy Cow, so obviously they have. It in Vegansk?
Yeah, okay, yeah. This is some dressing.
Yeah, this is that, yeah.
Or chili or Vegansk.
Yeah.
Det er normal falafla med basil og koriander. Det med rødbed og ingefær falafla og det med kålrod og lidt chili.
Ja.
Ja. Og det kommer med pål og det kommer med rabos.
Det er tak fordi I lader mig smøre på det her. Ja. Jeg tror faktisk den her, som du lidt på her, var den bedste.
Ja.
Den var meget god.
This is like crispy spicy. It's great.
I think it's absolutely amazing. Try this place out if you ever go to Odense.
I met another vegan inside of there and we talked for hours. Yeah, I just stood there and that was like no seats where I stood, so I basically have been standing for hours without thinking about it, and now I started to walk and yeah, I probably should sit down soon.
I just realized by seeing this, the National Archive in Denmark is actually in Odense. It's a really beautiful building. Apparently the other vegetarian place is just by where I stay. I didn't even know that place existed, which is quite interesting to say the least. I'm basically heading back while looking for that place. It's so strange that the one that I live with now doesn't have any idea where anything is. Now, it's very hidden, but this is called Kærnehuset. A vegetarian club on the webpage, it says. Yeah, it looks great, but it looks very hidden. I'll see if I can find the entrance. I go into the entrance and I see all of these different things. But I have absolutely no idea where I'm supposed to go. It's like there's some stairs, there's some doors, I don't know. This is the last sign I see. I got inside and I figured this is actually a food club. Where they specifically said that they're mainly going to focus on vegetarian. But seemingly, that they make something vegan is happening quite often, and even if they don't make everything vegan, there's often some of the dishes that they make that are vegan.
So,
So Kærnehuset has been open since 1977. It is still vegetarian. They have talked about making it vegan and they decided to keep it vegetarian. Though today everything was vegan. However, if you are a vegan and you live in Odense. Just call them up and ask if what they make today is vegan, and see if you can just bring even more vegans there, because eventually they're gonna have to change. That is like my idea. I kind of like turned the average age down quite a bit. Most people there were older adults. So yeah, extremely interesting.
Like I showed you in the other video, the water levels are just increasing.